You're not seeing Cleber sit in the guard, trying to get position. No, he is moving. Oof. This is what Cleber wants.
Sousa wants it. Here we go. Yeah, mutual respect. Guys would be so mad that they would lose to me because he looked so unassuming and immediately kind of scoots into this fight.
Yeah, immediately Cleber starts looking to pass that guard and get as tight on Musumeci as possible because he's going to have to shut down Musumeci's movement. Here's Musumeci getting in on the leg. Cleber's having a hard time getting that leg free. Oh, that's exposing the heel right here. He's trying to get that single X. Good job by Cleber to avoid the leg locks of Mikey Musumeci.
I love the way that Musumeci works off of his back with those legs. He used them, his feet are like an extra set of hands.
Yeah, he's so good at utilizing his legs and really just controlling positions. Watch how he creates frames, and he's looking to set up possible leg locks here. You can see him reaching in for the legs, trying to grab the heels, and Cleber's trying to pass the guard, trying to get past the legs of Mikey Musumeci. This is a contrast in styles. He's almost got past the guard, but Mikey does a beautiful job of keeping a frame with his leg, getting that knee shield going on, and then trapping the leg. Now he's got the leg. Cleber's got to move. Cleber's got to move. He's first going to get the knee past the hip line. He does just that. Now he's going to try to create separation of the legs.
Musumeci trying to lock it in here.
Yeah, Mikey is relentless with these leg attacks.
What's amazing here is that Cleber had his knee passed out of danger and Mikey with Mikey's legs, but Mikey started attacking the ankle there and then used that to pull the knee back inside the fulcrum. So Cleber was never actually out of danger at any point until he was completely free.
I like the way Kleber's using his feet to free from the hands of Mikey. There's a nice little cartwheel pass right there as he tries to get past the guard of Mikey, but Mikey is so good at retaining guard and getting a hold of these legs. Kleber's got to be careful here. Every single time he enters the pocket, Mikey's grabbing onto those legs with ultra-fast quickness. Cleber goes after a leg as well, but gives up his leg in the process.
Again, it's one 10-minute round. We're just over 2 minutes into this.
Oh, beautiful crossover there as Mikey's got the leg, looking for the heel hook.
This is high-level grappling from both of these guys, man. Kleber's doing an amazing job of being able to he's on the defensive the whole time here, but he's predicting everything that Musumeci's doing.
I mean, these two guys know each other so well, in and out.
Yeah, they haven't met in 5 years. Both their matches were in 2017. So 5 years later, we get the opportunity to see a rubber match, and it's for gold, which is amazing. But these guys have been studying each other along the way. You know, just like me, Cleber has been watching Mikey Musumeci's instructionals, so he knows exactly what Mikey's going to try to be doing. But Mikey's so innovative. He evolves every single day as a grappler.
I'm just looking at how
we trap the arm.
How impossible it is to actually pass Mikey's guard.
Yeah, he's incredible at guard retention. He's got the arm right here. Might be looking for a straight arm lock as Cleber's trying to defend and slide the arm
escapes.
Right out.
Again, Mikey so comfortable just laying on his back, waiting for Sousa to come in.
Little attempt there at the guard pass to get past the legs of Mikey, but Mikey falls into a leg entanglement.
This thing either ends on submission or the most legitimate attempts at submission.
This is a smart.
Mikey trying to go after the heel, trying to expose the heel right here. Cleber's got to be careful. Mikey's got him all wrapped up. Look at the triangle that he's got locked up here on the legs. Good job by Cleber to start peeling the legs off, right? So as soon as Mikey tries to get his leg into position, Kleber's trying to peel the leg off, put the foot on the hips and create space. The referee just called for a catch. That's going to score. Kleber's going to go after a foot of his own.
It's a really smart strategy by Mikey because Kleber's the one who's trying to enter the guard the entire time. And as he's entering the guard, it's forcing him on the defensive immediately. Like, he never actually has time to make an offensive movement from entering the guard.
Mitch, how much does stamina play into this in one 10-minute round?
Incredibly, because you have to keep, look at the pace at which Cleber is attacking, right? The way that he's consistently putting pressure on Mikey, it's extremely hard to keep that pace over a 10-minute round. It's not just 5 minutes where you get a break in between. It is a 10-minute continuous round of just constant attacking and moving. There's no stalling. You're not seeing Cleber sit in the guard, trying to get position. No, he is moving. Oof. This is what Cleber wants.
Sousa wants it. Here we go.
Yeah, Cleber didn't want up against the fence. He thinks that's going to hinder his ability to move and pass, so he's going to keep pulling Mikey out into the middle of the circle.
Mikey told us that Cleber is so tough to submit. He's just so strong. But every second, I'm going for the finish, and you can see that here.
You can see the way he's stepping on the leg to try to get a limb isolated, but Mikey is just so good at utilizing all of his legs, all of his arms together in unison. Almost with the pass, good knee shield right there from Mikey as Cleber tries to push the legs to the side so that he can get into a side control position, but Mikey is so good at keeping his legs in front of Cleber.
I wonder what would happen here if Cleber decided to drop the guard on his side and forced Mikey to come on top of him.
Well, Mikey did that with Imanari, right? They both just sat there and they started playing legs, right? So even in the guard, you know, Cleber is going to have to defend these leg attempts coming from Mikey. He's always looking at this. Look, anything that Kleber's going to give him, Mikey's going to try to take it, right? Now he's got the arm, right? The elbow is almost out.
Main event to come. Right after this one, strawweight world title fight, Zhang versus Lee 3, the trilogy fight. Again, that's immediately after this world title fight in submission grappling. First ever submission grappling world title fight here in ONE Championship.
Rich, you're a BJJ black belt. Why is this so hard to deal with for Cleber?
Because Mikey has such flexibility that when you go to pass someone's guard normally, like you can pick them up and fold them, right? But Mikey has the ability to still have mobility if his knees are, for example, touching his nose. His inversion guard is so good that you can never actually get past the legs. So while Cleber, you can see him pushing here on the left leg like he's trying to make his way past one leg. The moment he does, Mikey brings his other leg in, and he never actually gets past anything. Now this has his arm entangled, so he's immediately defending some sort of submission, even if it doesn't lock all the way in. And then Mikey immediately transitions to a leg, and this Kleber's just kind of trying to force the offense to be on the run the whole time simultaneously.
That was beautiful, right? Like he had the leg, he was attacking the leg. Cleber pushed down on one of Mikey's legs and Mikey transitions to an arm. It's just this constant attacking.
I love the fact that the audience is into this match because there's actually a wave going around the stadium right now. And that's how much they're appreciating this high-level grappling action.
2:20 to go. If it doesn't end in a submission, it's most legitimate attempts. If this fight ended right now, who would this decision go to?
Well, the referee called for a catch for Mikey, but it's up to the judge's discretion to determine whether that was a legitimate attempt or not. And right now, Mikey is the one that seems like he's attacking more, right? He seems like he's putting Cleber on his back foot, so to speak, in a defensive position where he's always defending what Mikey's doing.
For those new to the sport, I think, you know, many people would think it's kind of crazy that the guy that is probably winning the fight is the guy that is just laying around on his back.
The guy that's on the bottom, right? Yep. In MMA, usually the guy that's on bottom is the one that's losing, but not in submission grappling, right?
He's so comfortable in that spot is Mikey Musumeci.
You probably want to note there that Mohamed Suleiman, the referee, called a catch on the ankle there.
90 seconds.
So that's been two catches that the referee has called for Mikey.
For Mikey.
And that was the first two matches. These guys both went to a decision in their first two matches. So that's the type of level that these guys are bringing. They know each other really well, and they're very well evenly matched. Well, that's
fine,
nice.
That
nice little trap
line
right there. Went to the gable grip. You can see him sliding out the side. Might have an arm. Cleber slides right out and continues on his relentless guard passing attempt. And Mikey continues to go after legs. And anything that Cleber gives him, he's going after it.
50 seconds for one of these men to get a submission here as it goes to the judges' cards. And now 40 seconds here in Singapore on this historic night. First ever flyweight submission grappling world championship.
Nice little attempt there at the guard pass, but Mikey just keeps his legs right there. They got 30 seconds left. This is a very pivotal 30 seconds.
Huge sense of urgency from both men with 22 seconds. There's that cartwheel again from Sousa.
You know, neither of these guys wanted to let this go to the decision, but man, Sousa right now has got to be feeling it, knowing, even though when Sulaiman called the catch on the second piece there with the heel hook and Sousa shook him off, there's got to be this sense of urgency, knowing, like, I must be behind on the scorecards if it's calling catches.
Final seconds go off the clock, and that is it. For the world title, a nice show put on by Musumeci and Sousa. The American against the Brazilian, and now we... Mikey Musumeci becomes the first world champion in submission grappling here in ONE Championship.